وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
The 18th, inshallah ta'ala, ibadah which the Salaf rahimahumullah used to come with is Dabtul Amal. They had precision in their actions. وَأَكْلِ الْحَلَالِ and eating that which is halal. Uhayb ibn al-Ward, he said, لَا يَكُنْ هَمُّ أَحَدِكُمْ فِي كَثْرَةِ الْعَمَلِ. He said, it shouldn't be the aspiration of any one of you to come with a lot of actions. Don't make that your aspiration, that you come with many, many actions. Then what should we do? وَلَكِنْ لِيَكُنْ هَمُّهُ فِي إِحْكَامِي وَتَحْسِينِ. But rather, be a person who thinks about mastering your actions, as in being precise in what you do, يعني doing it in the right way, being a person who masters what they do, so it becomes easy for you to do it, perfecting it and making it correct, make that your aspiration. فَإِنَّ الْعَبْدَ قَدْ يُصَلِّي. Because a person can pray a lot. وَهُوَ يَعْصِي. But he's disobeying Allah. In what? في صلاة, in the salah that he's praying. So he's praying a lot, but he's disobeying Allah in the prayer. وَقَدْ يَصُومُ, he said. A person may even fast. وَهُوَ يَعْصِي اللَّهَ, and he's disobeying Allah in his fasting. في صيامي. وَلَوْ قُمْتَ قِيَامَ هَذِهِ السَّارِيَةِ. And then he said something powerful. He said, if you stand and you worship Allah and you stand up so still, like this pillar. So he pointed at the pillar in the masjid. If you stand still like this pillar, مَا نَفَعَكَ, it won't benefit you. يعني you're so calm, you're so straight, you are upright in your prayer, it won't benefit you. حَتَّى تَنْظُرَ, until you look at مَا يَدْخُلُ بَطْنَكَ أَحَلَالٌ أَمْ حَرَامٌ, until you look at what goes into your mouth and enters your stomach. Is it halal or is it haram? So two things he mentioned. ضَبْطُ الْعَمَلِ, precision in your actions. And also, looking at what you eat, your intakes. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his slave boy one day came to him. فَجَاءَهُ بِلَبَنٍ, he brought to him a milk, a cup of milk. فَشَارِبَ أَبُو بَكَر, Abu Bakr drank the milk. After Abu Bakr drank the milk, the slave boy said to Abu Bakr that he got this milk from kahana takahana biha. He said, I got this from this money came from where I bought the milk with fortune telling that I did, and I'm not good at it, he said. Fa'adkhala Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr placed his finger, yadahu, his finger, and he placed it in what? Fi fami, into his mouth. Faqa'a, and then he vomited everything out. Everything that was in his stomach, he vomited all out. Faqa'a kulla ma fi batnihi. Waqala, and then he said, law lam takhruj. He said, if you don't come out, everything that's in me, illa ma'a khuruji ruhi. If you don't come out, everything that's in me, except by me dying, yani by me taking my soul with it, la akhrajtuha, I will do that to myself. And then he said, Allahumma, oh Allah, inni a'tadiru ilayka ma hamalat al-uruq wal am'a. Oh Allah, I ask forgiveness from you. That which has entered my veins, that I can't stop, or entered my stomach, I can't stop that. Oh Allah, I ask for your forgiveness in that, and that you excuse me for that. This shows you how they were people who stayed away from that which was haram. Number 19. في لزوم الطاعة وترك المعصية. How they left of sins and they were consistent upon obedience. سعيد بن المسيب said, ما أكرمت العباد أنفسها بمثل طاعة الله ولا أهانت أنفسها بمثل معصية الله. سعيد said, رحمه الله, that the slaves, they do not, I mean, they haven't honored themselves. They haven't honored themselves anything equal to the way that they can do it by obeying Allah. Yani, there is nothing that is more honoring for a person than obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is nothing more humiliating. وَلَا أَهَانَتْ أَنفُسَهَا بِمِثْلِ مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ. And there is nothing more humiliating then disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani the person becomes nothing, insignificant. And if he obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he becomes honorable. Ibn Uyayna, Sufyan ibn Uyayna said, لَمْ يَجْتَهِدْ أَحَدٌ قَطْ. Ibn Uyayna said, there is no person who strives, ijtihadan, a striving. There is not a person who strives, a striving. And he strives very hard. وَلَمْ يَتَعَبَّدْ أَحَدٌ عِبَادَةً بِأَفْضَلَ مِنْ تَرْكِ مَا نَهَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. Ibn Uyayna said, there is not a person who strives or who worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala better than the one who stays away from that which he was prohibited from. And the best form of striving, the best form of ibadah a person can come with is to leave off that which Allah prohibited from you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said something powerful regarding this issue of luzum al-ta'a, being consistent upon obedience of Allah and staying away from that which you've been prohibited from and staying away from the sins. Our mother Aisha said, إِنَّكُمْ لَن تَلْقَوُوا اللَّهَ بِشَيْءٍ خَيْرٍ لَكُمْ مِنْ قِلَّةِ الذُّنُوبِ. There is nothing you can meet Allah Azza wa Jalla better than a minimal sin. And the best way you can meet Allah is to have little bit of sins. Humans can't come without no sins. But the best thing for you to meet Allah Azza wa Jalla is that your sins are very little. Now we move on to the 20th point of the ibadah of the Salaf rahimahumullah. And this is concerning the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how they were scared of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Ibn Abi Mulaika, he said, أَدْرَكْتُ سَبْعِينَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Ibn Abi Mulaika said, I met 70 of the companions of the Prophet. كُلُّهُمْ يَخَافُ النِّفَاقَ عَلَى نَفْسِي. And every one of them feared hypocrisy for himself. Every one of them. And Umar radiallahu anhu, who was a man who was promised Jannah alive, while he was walking on this earth, he was told he's going to enter Jannah. Umar radiallahu anhu. And the Prophet even went on to say that I went to your Jannah, Umar. I saw your Jannah. And Abu Umar radiallahu anhu is from the 10 who were promised Jannah. Asharul Mubashareena bil Jannah. Ma'a dhalika, he came to Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman and he said to him, هَلْ ذَكَرَنِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ هَلْ ذَكَرَنِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ مَعَ مَنْ ذَكَرَ مِنَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ. Did the Prophet mention me? Did the Prophet state me with the hypocrites? Was I mentioned with the hypocrites? Umar radiallahu anhu is scared. He's scared of being from the hypocrites. That's how the Salaf al-Salih were, the pious predecessors. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum. The final and last ibadah, the 21st, which is the final ibadah that the Salaf rahimahumullah used to come with, that I'm going to mention and conclude with, is al-istidadu lil-akhirah, preparation for the hereafter. Masruq ibn Abd al-Rahman, he said, إِذَا بَلَغَ أَحَدُكُمْ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً. If one of you reaches 40 years of age, فَلْيَأْخُذْ حِذْرَهُ. Take your precautions. Your time is now ending. 40 years, if you reach it, take your precautions. فَلْيَأْخُذْ حِذْرَهُ. Abu Hamza, he said, about Sufyan, about Safwan ibn Sulaym, Abu Hamza said about Safwan ibn Sulaym. We spoke about Safwan ibn Sulaym before. It was said about him, وَلَوْ قِيلَ لَهُ غَدًا يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. Tomorrow is the day of judgment. If it was said to Safwan ibn Sulaym, tomorrow is Qiyamah. يوم الآخرة is tomorrow. مَا كَانَ عِنْدَهُ مَزِيدٌ عَلَى مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْعِبَادَةِ. There was nothing more that Safwan ibn Sulaym could do, Abu Hamza saying. Abu Muslim al-Khawlani said, لَوْ قِيلَ لِي. If someone was to come to me now and to tell me, إِنَّ جَهَنَّمَ تُسَعَّرْ. That Jahannam is coming, is roaring this direction, it's coming to me. مَسْتَطَعْتُ أَنْ أَزِيدَ فِي عَمَلِي. I have no knowledge, I don't know. And I don't believe I have the ability to add on to any of my actions right now. يعني Jahannam is coming, and I was said, you're going to die right now. Hey, quickly, what are you going to do? I wouldn't know anything I can add on to what I'm already doing. Abu Hazim, he said, ما أحببت أن يكون معك في الآخرة فقدمه اليوم وما كرهت أن يكون معك في الآخرة فاتركه اليوم. Powerful advice. Whatever you love for it to be for you the day of judgment, then put it forward today. And whatever you want, so whatever you hate to be with you the day of judgment, then stay away from it now. Think about it. Whatever you want to be with you the day of judgment, put it forward. And whatever you dislike and you hate for it to be with you the day of judgment, then stay away from it now. Avoid it. This truly gives us an understanding of the Salaf, rahimahumullah, that their ibadah was holistic. All of those jawanib, all of those perspectives, all of those angles that I've spoken about, they were the forefront. And it shows you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is the type of people he nurtured. And this is the type of teaching he left behind, alayhi salatu wasalam. I encourage you all, inshallah ta'ala, to take note of these points. Inshallah ta'ala, to place it somewhere close to you. That whenever you feel that your iman is low, whenever you feel that you're not doing as much as you want to do, that you take it forward and you look at these points and you try to rectify your life with it. I myself have learned a lot from this preparation of this lecture. It's truly been an encouraging iman boost for myself. And I don't think I was the most fittest person to talk about this topic. And this topic itself requires a person who has ibadat, a person who's hardworking, a person who has those qualities. And I definitely am very short on those things. May Allah forgive me for what you guys don't know about me and make me better than what you think of me. Also, I would encourage you all to go to the kitab Tariqul Hijratain by Ibn al-Qayyim. This kitab Tariqul Hijratain by Ibn al-Qayyim, he has written down a daily routine for the student of knowledge. A daily routine. Not for the student of knowledge, sorry. He has written a daily routine for every Muslim. Yani when you wake up, until you go to sleep, what you should be doing. Inshallah ta'ala, if there's life remaining for us, inshallah ta'ala, we live on, I will inshallah ta'ala take that part of the kitab and make an explanation on it and discuss it and talk about it, inshallah ta'ala. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is for me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.